Do you remember the opening scene of Saving Private Ryan, when Allied forces were pinned down by heavy machine gun fire from the bunkers on Omaha Beach? And then they jumped over the sides of the boats into the water to avoid being hit by stray bullets. There are countless such scenes in films that show people diving into a body of water to avoid being hit by a bullet. However, it remains a great mystery whether being underwater can save you from bullets due to the varied levels of success that movies display in such a scenario. As you likely know, every medium offers some resistance to the movement of an object as it passes through it. For example, the air surrounding us offers resistance to our common movements, such as walking or running, as we move through it. However, we have become accustomed to ignore this resistance, unlike the resistance we feel when swimming. This resistance, or the resistance that a liquid has to the movement of an object passing through it, is called drag. Drag is the pulling force that slows you down as you swim. It is the same force that counteracts the forward motion of a ball. A ball sails easily enough through the air towards a target, but as soon as it breaks the surface of water, things change dramatically. Similarly, once a bullet enters the water, it must work extra hard against the natural resistance of the liquid to keep moving. In the case of most bullets, they do not go more than a few feet. The drag force is the biggest cause for concern for a bullet attempting to go fast and deep underwater. However, is the drag offered by water identical for everything that moves through it? The drag force depends on several factors, including the type of bullet, its velocity when fired, the drag coefficient of the bullet, and the time it is spent in the water. It also depends on the density of the fluid in question. The drag force of water is directly proportional to the speed of the bullet. This means that the higher the speed of the bullet, the more opposition will be offered by the water against its continued movement. Also, the denser a fluid is, the slower a bullet will move as it continues forward. The density of water is higher than air, so a bullet will slow down much more quickly in water. MythBusters, a popular Discovery Channel program, tested this bulletproof ability of water in one of its episodes. After shooting into the water with a variety of rifles, including a 9mm pistol, shotgun, a semi-automatic supersonic rifle, and a 50 caliber rifle, they concluded that you could protect yourself from an underwater onslaught of bullets from most rifles. In real life, however, a bullet is rarely fired from a position directly above the water. Thus, if the bullet is shot from an angle of 30 degrees, then being underwater at a depth of 3 to 5 feet, your immersion can ensure your safety from most guns. As it turns out, most films are scientifically accurate when they show the protagonist jumping into a body of water to escape a hail of bullets. I suppose it's okay to believe in the Hollywood magic sometimes.